What's going on, everybody? Kalipas Tech here, coming back at you with another video. In this video, we're going to be doing a comparison between the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G and the Blue G91 Pro. Now, before we go any further, I do want to remind you to go ahead and hit that subscribe button. It helps out the channel a lot. But with that being said, let's get into the video. So the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G has a 6.82 inch IPS LCD display with a resolution of 720p, a PPI of 263, and an aspect ratio of 20:9. We got a water drop notch up here for the front-facing camera, and this camera is 16 megapixels. Overall, the bezels are decently thin, and I think the display looks really nice. The biggest advantage of this phone's display is the size. At 6.82 inches, it's definitely one of the larger phones out there, which is gonna be real good for content consumption. So if you're streaming videos, playing a game, viewing photos, even reading, having a larger display is gonna make everything look a lot better because it'll all be larger and easier to see. So that's a good thing about this phone. Not the highest resolution or anything like that, but the size, I think, really makes up for this. Now, the con to having a large display with this phone is it's a little bit bulky and not the most comfortable to hold or carry around. I personally don't mind it, but if you don't like to have a huge phone, then this might be a deterrence for you. Now, the Blue G91 Pro has a 6.7 inch LCD display with a resolution of 1080p, a PPI of 395, and an aspect ratio of 20:9. We got a hole punch for the front-facing camera up here, and this camera is also 16 megapixels. I think the hole punch looks a lot nicer and cleaner than the water drop notch, and it gives the phone a nice modern look. I do think the bezels are pretty much the same size. Maybe the G91 Pro might have slightly smaller bezels, but I don't think it's really that much of a difference. But without a doubt, the Revel V Plus is definitely bigger. So that's gonna make a difference when you're streaming videos and stuff like that. So keep that in mind if you do want a larger display. The T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G is gonna have an advantage. But on the other hand, the Blue G91 Pro does have a higher resolution, and I do think this makes a difference. With the 1080p resolution, I do think it looks a lot better versus having only 720p. And another thing to keep in mind is that at 6.7 inches, sure, it's not as big as the Revel V Plus 5G, but the Blue G91 Pro still does have a larger than average display. So if you do want a blend of having a large display and a higher resolution, the Blue G91 Pro might be a better compromise. Another thing is the Blue G91 Pro, I don't know if it's technically actually thinner. It doesn't really look much thinner, but for whatever reason, whether it actually is a little bit thinner, maybe it's the rounded edges, or maybe it's just because the Blue G91 Pro is just over a tenth of an inch smaller. This phone is much more comfortable to hold in your hand and carry around in your pocket. I don't 100% know why, but it is. So if you do want a phone that's more comfortable, if that's something you really care about, then the Blue G91 Pro is gonna have an advantage. For storage, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G has 64 gigabytes of internal storage with microSD card expansion, and the Blue G91 Pro has 128 gigabytes, also with microSD card expansion. So as far as storage goes, of course, the Blue G91 Pro is gonna have a huge advantage here. Now, 64 gigabytes isn't really bad, but if you're a power user, you're definitely gonna want the extra space. And even if you're not, apps, files, the system, pretty much everything is all getting larger and larger as time goes on and taking up more space. So you might want to think about getting something with a little bit more storage just in case you need it, because it's better to have it and never need it than it would be to run out of space. Now, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G does not have wireless charging. No surprise there, because most phones that aren't flagship phones don't have that feature. But the Blue G91 Pro is actually an exception here, because it does support 10 watt wireless charging. This feature is not a game changer by any means, but if you do want the feature, of course the Blue G91 Pro is gonna be the better option because it actually has it. As far as security options, these phones have the same kind of stuff, face unlock and fingerprint scanners, but pretty much every phone in this price range is gonna have that same kind of stuff, except for the few oddballs that don't have a fingerprint scanner or don't have face unlock. But regardless, let's give these fingerprint scanners a try and see how they work on each phone. So with the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G, we got a fingerprint scanner right here on the power key with the little T-Mobile coloring. I really like this color scheme. Some people might think it's corny, but I personally think it goes really well with the phone. Power key fingerprint scanners are some of my favorite fingerprint scanners because of how convenient and usually fast they are. So let's see how this one works. There we go, one more time. And there we go. As you can see, it's real fast and responsive. No issues here. The Blue G91 Pro has a more traditional fingerprint scanner, being right here on the back. Not bad at all. On this specific phone, I thought it would have been nice to have an in-display fingerprint scanner, but it's not really a big deal. So let's give it a try. There we go, one more time. And as you can see, this fingerprint scanner is just as fast as the other one, so both of them do work really well. So taking a look at the rear camera setup, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G has a 16 megapixel main camera, a 5 megapixel ultra-wide camera, and a 2 megapixel depth sensing camera for portrait mode. For video, the phone has a max quality of 2K in both the rear and the front cameras. I'm not a big fan of 2K, I don't really see a point to it. I feel like if you want to shoot in a higher resolution than 1080p, you might as well just go to 4K, which this phone doesn't have. So I guess it's a good thing that this phone has 2K, but I personally just don't see a use for it. But other than that, the rest of the camera setup is pretty good. There's no macro camera. I personally don't use that feature, so it doesn't bother me. But if you do want a macro camera, this is not going to be the phone for you, because of course it doesn't have one. But it does have an ultra-wide camera, which is good. And the main camera is great for both regular pictures and portrait mode. With the Blue G91 Pro, we got a quad camera setup with a 48 megapixel main camera, a 5 megapixel ultra-wide camera, a 2 megapixel depth sensing camera, and a 2 megapixel macro camera. For video, this phone has a max shooting quality of 4K in the rear camera and 1080p in the front. So overall, neither of these phones have bad camera setups, but I would absolutely give the advantage to the Blue G91 Pro because this phone not only has a lot more features in general, but it can also shoot 4K videos versus 2K. And unlike 2K, 4K can actually be useful. So if you're looking for a phone that has a great camera setup and are planning to take a lot of photos to keep, whether it's for social media or something more professional, the Blue G91 Pro is going to be the better option. Internally, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G is getting 4GB of RAM with the MediaTek Dimensity 700 processor. Before even doing any tests on it, I already knew this phone was going to be strong. That's a great processor. It's in a lot of mid-range 5G phones, and it's consistently impressed me. But all the same, I did run a Geekbench 5 benchmark test on it, and it came back with a single core score of 541 and a multi-core score of 1692. So again, this is a really powerful processor, and there's not going to be a whole lot that you can't do at all. Maybe if you're playing a higher-end game like Fortnite, it might struggle when you have it in the highest settings. Or maybe if you're editing a large video, something like that, it might not do the best. And of course, if you compare this to like an iPhone or a high-end Samsung phone, of course it's not going to be at flagship level like those. But for everyday tasks like browsing the web, going on social media, that sort of thing, this phone is going to be really fast and it's definitely going to get the job done. The Blue G91 Pro is getting 6GB of RAM with the MediaTek Helio G90 processor. Right away, we see that this phone does have 2GB more RAM than the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G. Now, this isn't always absolutely going to make a huge difference because RAM by itself isn't everything. For that matter, the iPhone 13 only has 4GB of RAM, and it has more processing power than both of these phones combined. But at the same time, since these phones are at a similar level, I would say that having a little bit more RAM does give the Blue G91 an advantage right away, just because it'll most likely be able to handle multitasking a little better. But that being said, I did run a Geekbench 5 benchmark test on this phone as well, and it came back with a single core score of 490 and a multi-core score of 1614. So head to head, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G does have a little bit more processing power than the Blue G91 Pro, but it's so close, I really don't think it's gonna make that much of a difference. The bottom line is, both of these phones have extremely powerful processors, and no matter what activities you're trying to do, most of the time, these phones are gonna get the job done really well. Another thing to keep in mind about these phones, speed and processor-wise, is that the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G, as the name suggests, is a 5G phone, and the Blue G91 Pro is not. So if you want a 5G phone, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G is going to be the one to go with, because again, it's a 5G phone, and the G91 Pro is not. Now, both of these phones have 5,000 milliamp hour batteries, which is great. But as far as the battery goes, overall, I would still give the advantage to the Blue G91 Pro because it has more versatility. For one thing, it supports 30 watt fast charging, whereas the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G only supports 18 watt. That's not gonna make a huge difference in and of itself, but if you do have a really powerful charger, and you need to get your phone charged up really quickly, of course the Blue G91 Pro is gonna charge a lot faster than the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G. Another advantage the Blue G91 Pro has, as far as battery goes, is supporting 10 watt wireless charging, because the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G doesn't support wireless charging at all. So overall, both of these phones have great batteries that are gonna give you a lot of life throughout the day, and down the road in terms of longevity, but the Blue G91 just gives you a little bit more flexibility in how you're able to charge your phone. Now on the flip side, one big advantage the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G has over the Blue G91 Pro is the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G has NFC and the Blue G91 Pro doesn't. In case you don't know what it is, NFC is the technology behind contactless mobile payment services like Google Pay and Samsung Pay. And if you don't have NFC, you can't use those features. And since they're becoming more and more popular, I feel like every phone should have it. Unfortunately, that's not the case because the Blue G91 Pro, with all its cool features, doesn't have NFC, which was a big disappointment to me. But on the bright side, the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G does have NFC. So if you're looking for a phone that has that feature, then this phone is going to be the one to go with. So in conclusion, which of these phones is better? I feel like in most ways, these phones are about equal, but each of them has strengths over the other for completely different purposes. If you want a real nice display to watch videos on or view photos or something like that, if you really care about graphics and you want a really good camera setup and more versatility with the battery, the Blue G91 Pro is gonna have an advantage in every way. Despite not having quite as large of a display, it has a much better quality display, and the image is just overall better. In addition to this, it also has more storage, so if you're a power user, you're probably gonna wanna go with this phone. It has a better camera setup in every way, and you get more charging options. Being able to support 30 watt fast charging and wireless charging is a really cool thing. But if you want the largest display possible, or if you want a 5G phone, or if you want a phone that supports NFC, then the T-Mobile Revel V Plus 5G is gonna be the way to go. But at the end of the day, both of these phones are really good. Some of the best mid-range phones you can get, in my opinion, and either of them will provide a lot of value for the money. But I hope you guys enjoyed the video, and I hope you found this information useful as well. If you did, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And as always, I will see you in the next video.